Welcome to Cooking with Kyle and Kenny.
It's actually Kenny and Kyle, but he's the star.
Today we're going to be making polka-dotted macaroni cheese. And we're using my brother Tony's cookbook that he won back in 1973 in his dried bake-off for making the tuna casserole. It's a family heirloom, and we've had it for generations.
We're very excited. And to follow up the polka-dotted macaroni and cheese, we're going to be making
chocolate chip cookies.
So we're going to get started right now, and we're glad that you've joined us. And are you ready, Kenny?
Ready when you are.
All right. Bon appetit. Here we go. We're going to start by boiling some water, and then we're going to be adding some macaroni to the boiling water, obviously.
Here's the recipe right here. I made this before when I was at apartment 6, you know, here in New England Village.
By the way, all the recipes you see today are going to be from this cookbook, and so they're not going to be the kinds of things we serve to the guys at the Village. We're very health conscious of the Village, and these are kind of 1973 versions of healthy. So, here we go. Now we just have to wait. Cooking is a lot of waiting.
I agree.
So what's going on, Kenny?
Well, years ago, my brother Tony used to be the athlete in our family.
Mm-hmm.
He used to do soccer and basketball. He had a bench press downstairs in our house in 76 Hammer Road in Brockton. But it wasn't until the 90s when I became the athlete, and I was involved in Special Olympics doing track and field and skiing and swimming and volleyball. Currently, I've been doing basketball and swimming.
How many gold medals do you have, Kenny?
It's hard to count, you know, because I...
Several
gold medals and silver and bronze, too. I've worked with so many people, so I want to thank Jim Scott for what he's done with me, you know, and Paul Anders.
So,
I want to say hello to my mom, my dad, my brother, my nephew, my niece. I'm very excited about filming this show today. I've been on camera in front of camera before.
And on the radio.
On the radio, I was filmed doing Germany's Who's Crying Now, the WZLX Turkey meeting queen.
Didn't we recently see you on the stage too, Ken?
Also recently I've been on the stage playing the Tin Man in The Wizard of Oz. But I did other shows before that. I was Danny Zuko in Grease. I was Ren in Footloose. And I was Lumiere in Beauty and the Beast. And I have all 4 DVDs in my collection.
Which is extensive. He has a very extensive collection of DVDs.
Also, I have records and cassettes and compact discs and videotapes. I'm very proud of my collection. I have a collection of different kinds of drawings and various scenes, you know.
Yep.
I'm a really talented artist.
You can put the book down.
Talented artist. Proud of my accomplishments.
Yeah, well, you have a lot to count among them. So we're going to be making the polka dot macaroni and cheese today. And what are the polka dots? People might be wondering how you get the macaroni and cheese to be polka dot.
They're simply frankfurters. That's another word for hot dogs. People should know that.
Right, because they don't think that we're giving them diseased macaroni, right?
Of course not.
No, we wouldn't.
Wouldn't think of it.
Yeah. So right now we're boiling the water, and we're going to let that happen. And then we're going to drain the macaroni just like you normally would. And then we're going to move on, okay?
Using cheddar cheese soup.
Yes, that's the
very special ingredient.
Which we found at the Stop & Shop, which I didn't even think they still made cheddar cheese soup, but they do.
We really needed it for this recipe.
I know. We have so many good recipes coming up, too. This show, by the way, we're going to be continuing with our next episode, which is going to be called Pizza Palooza. And it's just like you think it is, pizza. And our friend Tim Cahill will be joining us on making his pizza because he does amazing pizzas, doesn't he?
Yeah, so.
But you don't eat vegetables.
No, I don't. I don't eat fruits either.
Isn't that ironic? And your last name is Delmonte.
Indeed, it's quite a coincidence.
Makes you think.
See, here's the recipe for Italian pizza.
It's so good. When you make it, it tastes so delicious. It's more
delicioso.
That too, yeah, exactly.
Delicioso.
Right. So I'm just waiting for the macaroni to get tender.
Yeah.
Like your heart.
I'm the squeaky clean cut guy. I don't smoke, I don't drink, I don't do drugs, I'm definitely against swearing.
I know you are.
But I do have knowledge of television and movies and music.
True.
Like, for instance, according to the Diary of Rock and Pop, which is an Irish newspaper I got called the Evening Press when I was living in Dublin, Ireland, it says that Journey became the first rock group to immortalize in a video arcade game named after their platinum album, Escape. You see, when an album sells a million copies, it goes both gold and platinum.
At the same time?
Exactly. Interesting fact.
I didn't know that. That's the nice thing about knowing you, Kenny. I always learn something I didn't know.
Indeed.
Kenny watches Jeopardy every night, so that's...
Wheel of Fortune first.
Yeah, obviously.
And I've had computer game versions of both TV game shows. I've played them several times, you know, with Pat Sajak, Vanna White, and Alex Trebek.
And what's the game that you always play on the computer? With that noise that I can't stand.
Archie Riverdale Rescue.
That's the one. It goes,
It involves Archie Andrews and his friends Betty Cooper, Veronica Lodge, Jughead Jones, Reginald Mantle, and everyone else who lives in the little town of Riverdale. I've read the comics many times, and I have episodes of the Archie Show on DVD, because they were a band known as the Archies, and they had the number one song on the charts called Sugar Sugar. I've seen the video of Ron Dante. He was the lead singer of the studio band. And also I've seen the Archies themselves performing it. And it features Sabrina the Teenage Witch.
And what does she say?
Well, all she does is give candy kisses and real kisses for only a dollar. Funny things happened when she gave kisses to both Reggie and Archie. And
what happened?
Reggie became a frog, and Archie became a rabbit.
That's insane.
Playing guitars.
Wait a minute. A frog with a guitar.
And a rabbit with a guitar, too. And Hot Dog, Jughead's pet, you know, through the kids, and he became a human clown, juggling ball, and riding a unicycle, and spinning a cane.
This sounds like, well, like a day in your head.
Yes. I have to bring the Teenage Witch on DVD. This was long before actress Melissa Joan Hart played her in the live-action television series. And I had a computer game featuring the voice of her called Sabrina Brad Attack. I have several collections of compact disc reading-only material DVDs with lots of games, including Wheel of Fortune and Jeopardy. And actually, years ago, back in 1999, I visited Universal Studios and I got to see the actual set from Wheel of Fortune. That made me very excited.
Did you spin when you saw it?
No, I don't think anyone was allowed to touch it.
I would have been spinning.
Or I would have taken a picture when I had a chance.
I would have been like this. L.
Matter what? R-S-T-L-E are the letters so popular in the bonus round.
I know, everybody chooses those. You have to wonder why they do that. But.
Well, here's a question about wonder why. Why does somebody always stick with the same category that somebody else chooses? And they choose a category, you know, and the...
People are very original, aren't they?
And the person, another person decides to stick with that category. They don't continue on with the category they chose unless they want to.
Well, you got to roll with the punches, Ken.
Obviously, it always happens. And I get slightly annoyed when the person with the most money finds that Daily Double increases their lead. I like it better when somebody else gets the Daily Double and tries to increase their lead.
See, I feel the same way when I watch Antiques Roadshow. I can't decide if I like the people that think their stuff is worth nothing and it's worth a lot, or the people that think their stuff is worth a lot and it's worth nothing. I can't decide which I like better.
Well, speaking of auto shows, I've been to the one in World of Wonder. Not World of Wonder, it's the World of Wheels. I got to see the actual General Lee that was used in the CBS TV series, The Dukes of Hazzard.
My brother wants a car like that.
Well, I have episodes of The Dukes of Hazzard on DVD. And I heard that the world of Wheels, appearing in the world of Wheels, is Ben Jones, who was Cooter on the Dukes of Hazzard.
Yeah, and you know what? He's going to be at an event coming up in New England pretty soon.
Sounds exciting to me.
I'd rather
That's the laughter of Roscoe
P. Coltrane.
Actually, I've seen him on both the episodes of The Twilight Zone and The Andy Griffith Show.
When you saw him, did you see a colander anywhere?
I haven't quite seen that.
Okay, let's see if we can find a colander.
I always like it best when all three contestants win on Wheel of Fortune, just as much as Pat Sajak does.
He doesn't play, does he?
No, but he likes it best when all three contestants win some money. That's what I mean.
Oh, well, that makes sense.
And I still remember the daytime version they had of Wheel of Fortune with this rotating room.
And how does Vanna White look younger now than she did in 1973?
She wasn't around that long. Wheel of Fortune made its debut in 82, and Vanna admits that she was very nervous.
I don't blame her. And how much did they spend on her clothes? A lot.
Yeah, she tries them on and they're taken away, you know. She doesn't get to keep them.
Do they give them to charity or something?
Maybe. Actually, I've seen her playing the Goddess of Love in a TV movie.
I remember that show.
Pat Sajak used to have his own late night talk show.
I remember. That was an unfortunate period of time.
Yeah, well, before Pat Sajak got on a White House of Wheel of Fortune, there was Chuck Woolery and Suzanne Stafford.
And what did Chuck Woolery say? We'll be back in 2-2.
I don't believe that you remember that.
I know, I'm weird.
I only know that he hosted two of the game shows, Scrabble and Love Connection. Because I remember one of the episodes of Scrabble, where the contestant wore sunglasses. So at the end of the show, Chuck went and wore a sunglass, and he said he felt real cool in them.
You wear sunglasses often, and you feel cool when that occurs, don't you?
Indeed.
Where's our recipe?
Page 72.
Oh, I'm sorry. Now, you have to guide me, or we're going to lose our way. As I'm pretty sure we're going to edit a lot of this anyway. So I have cooked and drained the macaroni.
Is it ready for the... ready for the cheddar cheese soup?
Let's see. What's the next step?
With a dainty bowl of the cheddar cheese soup, 10.5 ounces.
Okay, we're doubling the recipe, so we have enough for everybody.
So that would be 20.5 ounces.
Okay.
20 is, 2 20s are, 2 10s are 20.
Right, that's correct.
And then we'll be adding half a cup of milk and Worcestershire sauce.
So then that's actually 21.
Sure, this will all work out in the end with this fine recipe we're making. It's been handed down for generations.
It's Betty Crocker. We can't go wrong.
You can't go wrong with Betty Crocker, a classic chef like her. Classic lady like her, with all her recipes.
Yeah. Okay, so our next step, what does it say here? Cook and drain. Okay, we've done that. Empty into bowl. That's what we're going to use.
1 pound, 10.5 ounces cheddar cheese soup.
Okay, I'm going to go grab that. I'll be right back. And we're using 2, because we're doubling the recipe.
Yes, it sounds to me like a good idea.
Yep. We're using Campbell's cheddar cheese soup from Stop and Shop.
Good.
Good. Exactly.
Precisely.
Now, do we add the chicken or the cheddar cheese soup first? We're getting sidetracked.
Yes.
Vanna White does that to people, doesn't she?
Yeah, well, I remember when Pat Sajak walked over
and
touched one of the letters. And touch the hyphen in the puzzle. I was mentioning with the daytime version, I wanted to mention in one of the episodes, Pat Sajak put on a man's fur coat because that was the prize they were offering.
Now this is very, 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 very delicious.
I'm sure it will be. All we can do is hope for the best.
And what do we do with tin cans?
Recycle them.
That's correct. And doesn't Pembroke have a wonderful recycling program that everyone should use?
Yes, recycling started back in the 1970s when I was a kid.
Really?
Really.
What, that's when they told us all we were supposed to use the metric system too, right?
Wanted to save the ecology, you know. And they used to have these green and white ecology flags.
I know, it doesn't look very...
I'm proud to have been a kid in that decade, you know, when we had disco music and rock, rock and roll films. You know, this year will mark the 40th anniversary of Star Wars, you know.
Really?
And Saturday Night Fever, that's all about disco.
You're making me feel old, Kenny, Delmonte. Okay, so now we've put the
cheddar cheese soup
into the bowl. And now we're going to stir in 1/2 cup milk.
And add Worcestershire sauce. Kyle has trouble pronouncing Worcestershire
sauce. I do not. It's Worcestershire.
See what I mean?
Worcestershire
sauce. See what I mean? It's sort of like a tongue twister, isn't it?
So we're going to add a cup of milk, because we're actually doubling our recipe. And if you want the recipe, by the way, just go ahead and let us know, and we'll get that to you right away, okay?
This book's available on the internet. I checked it out some weeks ago.
You did?
Last month. I found this book available.
Very
classic. It's a classic.
Resourceful of you, Kenny.
I wanted to get a new copy, my mom's managed to save this for me.
Your mother is lovely.
Indeed.
Okay, so I've mixed the cheddar cheese soup with the milk, which is managing not to make me feel as disgusting as I should feel. And we're going to add the
Worcestershire sauce.
The Worcestershire.
1 teaspoon. If you like, it says, actually. Actually, it says if you like.
Well, we like, don't we?
Definitely.
Okay, let's grab the Worcestershire sauce. Okay, I think I threw it in the refrigerator, even though it doesn't need to be refrigerated. Did I put it in there?
Here we are.
Here.
All set.
Stop and chop and
Worcestershire sauce.
Yeah, that.
I pronounce it better than you do, obviously.
You do, yeah.
It does sound like a tongue twister, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's got so many syllables. All right, so how much does the recipe say?
1 teaspoon.
So we're going to do 2 teaspoons, and they're in here. As you can tell, this is our first episode, so...
No, it's connecting the dots.
Yes, connecting the dots. Okay, so this is a tablespoon. That's too big. We need a teaspoon. And Kyle Harney on the spoons.
What a sense of humor he has.
I'm the ham and the cheese.
Yes, okay. Exactly.
Right. All righty. And of course, these things are all... I guess we'll just wing it. Shall we wing it? Well, we don't want to wing it. We're gonna... I always remember that the tablespoon is bigger than the teaspoon because you put a cup of tea on a table.
You got that right.
All right, so here goes the Worcestershire sauce.
Well, sounds like you're stuttering.
Yeah, it does, doesn't it?
In a way.
Doesn't it? We know somebody else who does that, I think.
Soon this will be ready for the oven.
Yes, and then we will put it into, what's the temperature?
375 degrees.
For how long?
25 minutes.
Okay, but I believe we're going to have to add the frankfurters as well.
Exactly.
And then we sit and we wait, which means Kenny will tell us all about something else.
Tell us all about different subjects. I can tell about KISS or,
you don't
or
believe
the WWE or something like that.
Okay.
I've got plenty of knowledge.
You do?
So I could give you a little KISS story.
I got that, okay.
That's the term they come up with in the history of KISS.
And what do they call people who follow KISS around?
The KISS Army.
But I was in the Navy, so can I be in the KISS Navy?
There is no KISS Navy. It started back in 1975 in Terre Haute, Indiana, when a man named Bill Starkey threatened a radio station saying that if you don't play KISS Records, the KISS Army will surround you. They thought it was a joke, but sure enough, dozens of people showed up at the radio station demanding to hear their favorite rock band. And that was the first official gathering of the KISS Army.
And were they, like, violent?
No, okay. I don't think so.
I hope not.
Okay. Here goes the macaroni.
Here goes the macaroni into the mixture of the cheddar cheese soup.
It's become soft, and the Worcestershire sauce.
And the Worcestershire.
With milk. Yeah. It's become soft and tender now.
Yes. Just like us.
So now let's all mix it all in.
Yes, we'll mix it all together. And then we're going to be cutting our frankfurters up.
We'll need a knife.
We will, and a cutting board.
Sorry, I scared you.
You did. Well, you pulled a knife on me. Kenny, Delmonte, you pulled a knife on me.
I was only getting what we need.
No.
You're just jumping to conclusions, my friend. What a sense of humor.
I know. I told you. I'm the ham and the cheese.
Okay, so this is what your macaroni should look like before you add the polka dots, which used to be my spy name during the war.
You're kidding.
Polka dot, that was my name.
What war?
The Cola War, I'm making it up.
The Cola War, that's what I figured.
No, the Cola War. Remember the Cola War in the 70s?
Well, that's what that was, the Korean War.
I wasn't in that one.
Vietnam.
No, I wasn't in that one either. How old do you think I am? You're older than I am.
Well, I come from a generation. I mentioned about Archie and his friends. But also,
did they go to war?
Well, actually, I have a series called the Archie Americana series in comic book collections. Comic books called trade paperbacks. That is the best of the 40s, the 50s, the 60s, the 70s, the 80s, and the 90s.
Which is your favorite? Probably the 70s, I bet.
Well, I like both the 70s and the 80s, you know. The age of disco music and the age of rock video and MTV music television. That was back in 1981 when I was just 14 years old.
I was in freshman in high school. Those were the days. Pardon me.
So many rock stars came out in the 80s, such as
Michael
Jackson.
And remember, you're the only one in the kitchen.
Jackson and Billy Idol and Prince, Phil Collins, you know.
People
told
me I look like Phil Collins because I have the same hairline.
Indeed. I hardly agree.
That's why I wear a hat now.
A scully cap, they call it.
Yes, they do.
It's popular in the United Kingdom.
I don't see a cutting board, but we have disinfected the countertop.
We can use some paper towels if you like.
Tim is pointing to me that we have one. We do in here? Here we go. Oh, and it'll set off the frankfurters in just such a marvelous light. I wish we could
improvise when you haven't got quite what you're looking for.
So we're going to use four because we're doubling the recipe. Penny, would you be so kind as to stick these back in the refrigerator?
My pleasure.
Outstanding. Because nothing is better in a kitchen than complimentary behavior, correct?
Precisely.
And you look so nice today, Ken. That's complimentary.
I'm color coordinator, so that's why I like to match colors like red.
You do. You always match. Okay, so we're going to...
I'm one of a kind.
That's true. Sweet Genevieve. I'm going to let you pepper the polka dots onto the macaroni and cheese. Isn't that exciting?
I'll do my best.
Okay. I know, and I know they will be quite random. So this is how you slice up a hot dog. If you can't figure that out, you probably go back to another.
Better to use a safer knife than a sharp one. That's highly dangerous.
I know, I could probably, you know, if I were a stick of butter, I could cut myself. But
Very funny.
I'm just as sweet as a stick of butter.
Okay. A real sweetheart.
That's me. You want to show them how we're going to polka dot the macaroni and cheese, Kenny?
Exactly.
Okay.
I knew you would need a response.
And you gave me one.
This is going to be an excellent recipe. I hope you all enjoy it once it's completed.
I know we will. Are we going to take the rest back to the apartment to share with our friends at apartment 5?
Sounds like a good idea to me. We should share.
We should.
Because I made this when I used to live in apartment 6 here in New England Village.
You did?
We're here at the Solar Wellness Center, which, back in 2005, I personally cut the ribbon to declare this place officially open.
With a butter knife?
With a pair of scissors.
Oh.
When we first came here, the swimming pool was just an experiment.
It's a fact.
we've
swum together in the pool.
And I've swum with several people, you know, and they brought along toys to use, you know, and rubber balls and...
What else do they have?
Hoops.
A hot tub.
Yeah, a jacuzzi.
Too hot in a hot tub. Okay. All right, now, Kenny, I'm going to give you these polka dots to add to the...
Let's begin. To the macaroni and cheese, let's begin.
Okay. Get this out of your way, sir.
I do my best to find the nicest thoughts for each of these. This will be an interesting recipe for everyone to try out.
I think so.
Should be. plenty for me to work with. There's nothing like an old-fashioned family recipe.
True.
Brighten up a cloudy day outside. Well, the weather isn't very warm, but
it's gonna be.
Spring has just begun, and the weather will get warmer in time, and soon we'll have flowers growing and leaves on the trees. You know, everything will be beautiful, and the weather will be warmer.
Yeah.
All we can do is hope for the best with Mother Nature.
You can never count on her, though. She can be quite a vicious woman sometimes.
Full of surprises, if you ask me. And there was also Father...
Boo!
There's Father Time, too.
That was me surprising him. Although you've come to expect that from me, so I guess it's not a surprise.
I suppose it is.
Okay. So, once Kenny's done with putting the polka dots on the macaroni and cheese, we will then do a polka for 25 minutes while the recipe bubbles in the oven, and that's at 375, and then it will be ready, and that should serve about 8 to 12 people. So we have some of our friends from apartment 5, and it's going into the oven right now. Are you ready, Kenny?
I'm ready.
Here it comes, people. When next you see it, it will be totally delicious.
This will be a delicious dish, I assure you all.
Just like me, I'm a delicious dish.
I'm Peter Brown from Tiny and Sons Glass. Tiny and Sons Glass was established in 1978 when my father and brother and I were at 575 Washington Street in Pembroke. We're certified and qualified to do all your windshield replacement and repair. Tiny and Sons Glass is a community-based business. We have 12 mobile vans that come to you. If the weather's bad, you can come here to the shop. We have a nice waiting area, TV, Wi-Fi, kid-friendly, pet-friendly. We also can move about 15, 20 cars a day through the shop. Perfect for you when the weather's bad. So come on down to Tiny and Sons Glass if you need your windshield replaced or repaired. Tiny and Sons Glass, 1-888-64-TINIES. Just call. Thank you.
Okay, so we're back, and it's almost time to unveil our delicious polka-dotted macaroni and cheese.
I'm ready when you are.
Okay, here we go.
You're right, Kyle.
I know, I'm a panic. Okay, people, here we go. So this is what it should look like when it's finished.
I'm sure everyone will enjoy it. It all comes out light and bubbly, you know?
Yes, and it just smells fantastic.
I just took a whiff.
What did you think?
Pretty good.
Thumbs up? Outstanding.
Two thumbs up.
Okay, so this is our creation for our first episode of Cooking with Kenny and Kyle. It is delicious polka-dotted macaroni and cheese, but this is only part one of Connecting the Dots. We will be doing part two of Connecting the Dots shortly, and that will be chocolate chip cookies.
Right? For dessert.
For dessert. So that
right,
will make
Kyle.
Your full entree, and we want to say to everybody, mwah! Enjoy. And we hope to see you again very soon.